Interwebs, it is I, the Autobot, and I am back for another Iron Man 2 toy review. Today I'm going to be doing this guy. You can kind of see, there we go. Get some better lighting in here. I am doing the comic series War Machine. Now, one thing that I like about this guy compared to the other Iron Man toys is that he doesn't have a stupid little rocket launcher thing that doesn't do anything. He has these things, which are tech accessories. You see here, he has a like a missile launcher, and he's got three missiles shooting out of it. And here is supposed to be his Gatling gun firing. It works. So yes, take these off. You can put this guy onto Movie War Machine's Gatling gun and have him have an effect, but I usually don't. Now, looking at this guy, he does look a little bland. And I love this guy. I love both of the War Machines. But he still is bland looking compared to the other guys, because it might be just because of the color gray they use. Or silver, I should say. It just looks a little bit bland to me. Let's move on to articulation. He has the arm pads that are attached to his waist, abdomen. He got a full 360-degree rotation in the arm, up, down. Same joints as before. Hand rotates somewhat. It almost goes full 360, but then it gets kind of stopped by that, so this hand, on the other hand, does rotate fully 360 degrees, and it kind of sort of has an arc reactor. You can kind of see it in there, but it isn't poseable enough to really use like that. Then you have the Hasbro hips. Turn it around and kick. Now this guy, unlike the other Iron Man toys, does not have the knee scoop of death. He just has a knee pad, a weird kind of knee pad in there, and he has the double jointed knee, and the foot has about that much articulation in it. That's about all you can do with it. I almost forgot, you also have a very limited waist joint that can turn, but you risk the chance of damaging the paint. And a head that somewhat turns, but that's about it. He looks like that, and that's it. Now let's go into the detail of this guy. Very nice sculpted detail, you can see right here. And it kind of gets washed out because it's all, you know, the gray, you know, the top part of his chest is just gray, then you have this bluish gray coming down, and then you just have this silver, and that's it for him. And it kind of washes out some of the details. Got this nice machine gun in here. At least what I believe is to be the machine gun. So yes, it's a nice toy. One of the nice things is this guy has, you know, two different guns on here. He's got his Gatling gun and his missile launcher, which is a nice change from Movie War Machine. And you can take them off and put them on the other side, but it doesn't work so well because, as you can see, this is for the missile launcher and this is for the regular Gatling gun. And this is built differently because when you try to put it on here, it's right up to his head. So yeah, he's a nice figure. Can't put him in too many poses. The best one I found, let me get these guys on here, is to kind of have him looking semi one way and having all of his guns turn that way. So, hold on. And like that. Now you got him kind of looking like he's gonna murder somebody. Then we have the obligatory bland stand. Yay! It's I keep calling it the bland stand, but it's nice for what it does. It gives you a good stand, actually pulls these guys pretty well, so can't really blame it for it. And then you have the three armor cards. They are what they are. So in closing, if you ask me whether or not you should get this guy, I'd say get him if you're a fan of War Machine. If you like who War Machine is, if you like the character, if you like the suit, get him. But he's not all that great imposing because of his limitations that he, well, because of his janky Hasbro hips, and because he really has no articulation in the waist. That's, yeah, if you're like me and you like War Machine a lot, or you just like the way this armor looks, get him, because he's worth it. If for nothing else to have your Hall of Armor, get him. He is well worth it. So, this is the Autobot and comic series War Machine signing off, reminding you all, until that day, till all are one. Pew pew! My wish is over.